never sleeps. Well, here we are, New York City, Times Square. We only landed 2 hours ago, myself and Claire, and we're just going to go watch the 28th November. Loads of Christmas lights, and there's always lights here. Hugh Jackman, Meredith Wilson, the music man. Winter Garden, Stardust, made by David Bowie. The renovator. I've done a bit of renovate myself, really. I just cut it now. Because we can still.
So it's Monday night, by the way. What, 28th? Monday the 28th. I don't know what them's doing up there. Big crowds here. A pair of sunglasses, all the bright lights. Let's see what's happening here. Well, it was a toss up between Lion King and Morrissey in Brooklyn. I've opted for Morrissey in Brooklyn. I love animals, but I'll say Lion King when it comes to Sunderland. So I take it that's when the bells for the new year. You watch the television. Big yellow taxis and the big yellow taxis anymore are still yellow. Oh, they're more orange and yellow. I don't know what ever happened to them. Last time I was in New York City was I did the marathon, the half marathon. 7 mile, I think it was 7.5 mile around Central Park. And then up here where we are now, Times Square. She's there. Yeah. Nice. Well, he's no Frank Sinatra, there was only one, but he's lying, but he's very, very good. I wonder who's singing Hail Hail Shelves are here. Smells in New York. There's the Radio City. As I mentioned earlier, you've had the Grateful Dead appearing there over the years. None of that is Fancy Horn, Bette Midler, Sting, and many, many others. Dare I say it, Barry Manilow. Stunning. Some of the other Christmas lights or whatever.
And then you go, this is her, look at her there. Who does she think she is? Who does she think she is? She thinks she's a kid. There she's there. That's Santa, Mrs. Santa. That's some crackpots in New York. So I should bring some of my mates over here.
Well, this is the place where Richard or John Lennon lived.
Facing Central Park. That's where he was shot. Tragically.
And I was a big Lennon fan. I'm still a Lennon fan. He was my
favourite Beatle.
It's a grand building.
Central Park's just down the road. So that's where Lennon, as I say, was tragically killed. This is Strawberry Fields, it's a tribute to Lennon. And as you come in the park, there's the Imagine. I've been here before, but I think the weather was pretty poor. So there you have it.
Quite
John Lennon. It's like Mary Lennon, Donnie Gollan, eh? It's not Mary Lennon. You're joking, aren't you? So by all accounts, this was David Bowie. I mean, a big fan of Bowie. He was the man that introduced me to music. Washington Square Park. This was his favourite park. Imagine the man that fell to earth, bottle through here. It's not very big, but it's cute. I like the lamps, old fashioned lamps. Come on, and this is Cafe Wa. See who's here. See who's been in it. Bob Dylan. Is this here? Bob Dylan's first ever gig in New York City.
Wow.
Ryan, this is for you, son. He's a big Bob Dylan fan. Jimi Hendrix. Jerry Lee Lewis, he was a singer, was he? An actor. The Velvet Underground. Springsteen. The Boss. Chuck Berry. Wow. When was it? The biggest swinging entertainment cafe in Greenwich Village. So this is Greenwich Village. 1959. Founded 1959. And it opens at 8 o'clock every night. There's a bit around here as well. Hey, Jimi Hendrix, good picture of Hendrix in it. Huh? That's quite good right now. Have a wee fun into this. By midnight, the party had begun. On stage, musicians offered up a Sousa's feast where singers captivated the audience with jazzy riffs, swivelling hips and the red lipstick swirls. The crowd waved their arms and swayed in their seats. By 1 a.m, they squeezed between tables to dance. At 3 a.m, ushers forced them out of the door, so ending a typical night at Cafe Wa on McDougall Street. See you later. And still on McDougall Street, this is where Bob Dylan lived. Bob Dylan. Yeah, I think we sounded it. There was too many people knew where he lived. Way before I knew, of course. Nice music in the background. So we're in Bleecker Street. This is where Dylan wrote a lot of his albums and songs. I think Desire was one of them. By all accounts, one of his guitars we sold this street for £70,000. I mean, that'd been many years ago, a lot of money then. I'm intrigued.
So this is where Dylan wrote Desire. It's called The Bitter End, still there amazingly. And 147, check it out. 147, is that the amount of goals I scored for Middlesbrough? And that's where he wrote.
Why, how's that for coincidence?
So 147, The Bitter End, Bob Dylan wrote Desire. I'm just letting you know there, I might pop in there for a new body.
Body work.
Well, this is equivalent to El Greco's in Rome. Well, I think it is anyway. Let's see. It's been here since 1927. Tell you what, I think the windows need a good clean, but do you know what? I'm going to go for a coffee. Let's see what it says here. This is talking about Dougal Street, as you can see. 27, established the original cappuccino and the oldest cafe in Greenwich Village. We're going in.
It looks the business like.
It does look the business. Very old fashioned like, but hey.
Hey ho.
Let's see. All the guitars, people playing instruments, how classy is this? What's it called again? What's it called, mate, this?
Music Inn.
Music Inn, yeah. Music Inn. How cool. Quite a shop there. Human League. How cool is that? Here's the hat, the Irish hat. Dude, God, look at them. Look at them, man. Brilliant, isn't it? For my mate Tom Corrigal, who teaches the boxing, Overthrow Boxing Club, over that, eh? How cool is that? Oh, what in the back? What in the back? Wow, how good is that? So here we are, a street named Joey Ramone. Remember the Ramones? Good band. Joey Ramone. Lovely day here in New York. Really, really nice. Well, we've just come off the subway there at the famous Macy's. If you know how the Macy's well. We don't know about New York. Vuitton, there's Claire, my wife, and I'm not going to dwell too much on her. Look at the lovely decorations for Christmas. How nice is that? Stunning. Let's go in there. Yeah?
Here we go. Welcome to Macy's, New York City. Sorry. This is for our video. Claire loves it. Right, she loves it. How nice is it? Go walk them.
Look at the dolphins who give love up.
Macy's at Christmas, who would have believed it? Thanks to the World Cup. And if you're watching this, no, I've not watched Thing on Wales. I thought seeing New York's more important. Nah, I'm only joking. Well, we're still in Macy's. This is at the very top floor, Holly the Lane it's called. This is seasonal, this is all year round, not just for Christmas. The last time I was here, I was with the late great Emily Brownlee. I've got a picture of the house we actually had up here. Sorry. Some lovely trees like that. The last time I was in the Madison Square Garden, it wasn't a boxing match, it was Barbra Streisand and the Ali progressing. This is a sneak preview, they're working, getting refurbished. So there you have it, there's proof. Well, here's the front of Macy's. There's all pigeons, no matter where you go, pigeons everywhere. I thought I'd say Alicia Keys was on. Obviously, the big man's on, the Mara Morrissey, forget Alicia Keys, but just by chance Alicia Keys was on. Lovely cathedral, that. St. Patrick's Cathedral, New York, massive. There's Pope John Paul, number 10. No, my name's met him. This is a great statue. As I say, the immigrants dedicated to the people of all nations who entered America through Castle Garden. Memory of Samuel Rudin, 1895-1975, whose parents arrived in America in 1883. You allow it to see it through the trees there.
Bright green, and then obviously there's New York.
Tonight you see Morrissey and Brooklyn. So this is a close up of Ellis Island, the immigrant put. This is a memorial for the World Trade Center. This is obviously a tribute. And there's the new World Trade Center there. Not the names of the people. Somebody's left a rose under Derek. Ogilvy sword. So sad. The names. Horrible. for the distance between the twin towers. Seventy steps. That's the gap between the twin towers. Love to see inside so far. It's very grand. It's a grand venue. Actually, it looks fairly dumpy. Grand, really grand. Very posh. Very grand. Well, it's only pleasant quality place. Down here, Claire. A grand. Grand.
That.
Going here, Claire, down the stair.
Let's have a look to above. Very grand. So you have it, getting closer. How grand is this? I mean, from outside you'd never believe it's less, would you? Incredible. What's with the view Moza gets for the stage?
If you don't give it to
I lost my voice in San Francisco.
So I say St. Patrick's Church, so you're going to see it. See what's inside. You see Pope John Paul. I remember meeting him in Rome, the Republic.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister Pat. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully embrace her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death and sin.
Go,
it's alright.
We just finally have found some food that I like. So happy to be back today. Just sitting in a wee park. All the seats that are here. Facing messes. Sun's shining. It's a bit cold to be fair, so I get a big jack up. Right, very nice. Check out this. Very nice. You don't get this on Lintop Road in the borough. Some noisy twats about here. We're inside Kennedy Airport. We're on the way home. I say, don't be kidded by the sun, it's absolute Baltic. Freezing.